My name is Craig Richardville, Chief Information Officer for Carolina's healthcare system. What we've seen as we started to digitize our industry is the ability to uniquely identify the patient is of the utmost importance. So as patients come in and come out of our system, come in and out of other healthcare systems, as people travel all the way across, to be able to look at that patient and get that holistic view of that patient is really important for us to deliver the appropriate care. If you look at EMPIs, and there are a lot of EMPI system solutions out there, and many different healthcare systems have their own. If you look at the reasons why we had something very similar to everybody else, but there's a human component of that. For me to be able to get your name, get your address, to get your birthday right, to be able to get your social right, your phone number right, and try to use all that information to come up with really uniquely identifying who I am. You look at duplicate medical records. You can find some areas running somewhere between 8% and 10%. Best practices was about between 4% and 5%. And we felt before we got into biometrics that we were pretty much at the leading edge. We were somewhere around the 4% to 5%, may periodically get down to 3%. But as we continue to add new healthcare systems into ours, the whole duplicate issue arose, not only within when we analyzed their information and said, boy, you got a lot of duplicates in the 10s and maybe 15% range, and then bringing them into ours, now all of a sudden we had another, you know, a bunch of patients that we had to continue to try to manually match up. We were looking at ways how to uniquely identify our patients and not be intrusive with social security numbers or other things that would be personal and confidential for our patients. By moving into the biometric space, we're running pretty consistently about a 0.08% duplicate. So at every one of our registration areas, we actually have the palm vein scanner. We do allow people to opt out. It's not a requirement, but it's a 99%+ of people that want to use the palm vein scanner. And the uniqueness of it is like a snowflake, right? So it's not the vein, or not the palm itself, the palm print itself, like a fingerprint that could be duplicated or false positives. It's the veins within it. It actually has done something for us that has been higher than our expectations. So it allows us to be able to be 20 times better than the national average of uniquely identifying our patients. And with that becomes the opportunity to ensure that we don't have duplicate medical records and we don't have overlays that are inappropriate, and allows us to be able to have our providers have confidence that when they go into a patient record, they'll be able to see the exact record and that complete record that we have on file for that patient, not that there's multiple ones out there.